For Zhao Dechin, the questions have not gone away, but neither, of course, has the pain, as raw now as it was then. The shrouds cover her twin daughters, Ya Qi and Ya Jia, killed when their school collapsed. This Sunday will mark the 5th anniversary of their deaths. Our biggest wish today is to have the government give us an explanation, she says. The Sichuan earthquake is one of the most destructive on record, leaving up to 90,000 people dead. But it was the collapse of so many school buildings that mixed anger and recrimination with the grief. 5 years on, it is still not easy to speak to parents who believe that shoddy construction was partly responsible for the deaths of their children. After being intercepted by the police, we were taken to a government office and told if we wanted to speak to families, they would choose them for us. And so our guided tour began. We were shown some of the hundreds of thousands of new homes that have been built, as well as people who seemed genuinely grateful, regardless of the constant presence of the officials. The preserved town of Beichuan is now a memorial to what is, for the Chinese government, a national victory of resilience over adversity.
That this was a huge and devastating force of nature is, of course, beyond dispute. But the idea that human culpability could also have played a role in the collapse of so many public buildings, especially schools, is seen as dangerously subversive. And still today, those allegations are being fiercely suppressed.
Zhao Dechin, who we finally met in secret, says her religion has kept her strong in the face of intimidation and constant surveillance. Whether officials should bear any responsibility or not, her story is one they don't want the world to hear. John Sudworth, BBC News, Sichuan.